With me today is Arif. He's my really good friend. So okay, before we start, Arif, are you a Marvel fan or a DC fan?
Marvel.
because the internet now is divided. You know, there's no comic book fan anymore. It's like, are you DC or are you Marvel?
Comic book is still comic books, okay? Fuck.
But I mean, you know, technically, comic book fan means both.
So you want to be a faction? You have to divide into factions, huh?
I mean, that's the internet.
It's like the Civil War side. It's like Iron Man or Iron Captain America.
Yeah,
right.
That's the internet.
Yeah, if that's the case, then I would still say I'm probably Team Marvel.
Well, for me, I
of course, Batman is the epitome of all heroes for me.
Okay.
But yeah, for me, I would say overall the universe appealing is more. Actually, I have to say it's more probably Marvel. The only DC thing for me still is the Joker Batman dynamic.
Yeah,
those two are crazy.
That's the thing. I think the cat
block.
The cat's tail. But yeah, I think one of the things is I'm very much a fan of Marvel heroes.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Like Thor, the Hulk, I think was one of my favorite ones. Spider-Man, of course. But DC, I much prefer the villains, you know, the Joker.
Okay, well, I come from comic book. I'm coming from a comic book perspective, okay, because
mm-hmm.
I actually do have them. Okay,
yeah.
Marvel is not as hard to follow as DC,
in my
opinion. Okay, that's it, because the characters they use tend to be mainstream characters, or at least characters that you will come across quite often,
mm-hmm.
Like DC, every so often they'll bring back a character from the silver age, you know, and That's what ticks me off the most. Like Blackest Night, where the you know this green Brightest Day, Blackest Night,
the Green Lantern
prophecy,
yeah.
Right? Like that series alone, it was an amazing game. I mean, it looked really appealing to me graphic wise.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the possibility of that, but they brought in back so many characters. I'm like, who the hell are you? Oh, you died by this guy. I'm like, oh shit. So that's the only issue with me and DC lah. If you want to follow the continuity, it's quite a struggle lah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sorry guys. This is my cat, okay? Nico, okay?
I have
60 cats at home,
yeah.
Right? So first time WALTR is actually
playing with me. This is his place actually.
Jeez.
So today we have Thor Ragnarok or
trailer.
Ragnarok, however you want to say it. I don't know.
Basically, Ragnarok is basically Armageddon for Asgard.
Okay,
it's the end. Okay, this is letting you know. Okay, this is the vision for Ragnarok. For
some people say it's good, but so. I don't know, we've just...
So this is the first time we were first watching the trailer.
So
I told him not to watch it. Okay, if you watched it, this is the last time you're going to see WALTR.
I literally haven't though, so let's go.
Okay.
This is
probably in Valhalla. The hell version of Asgard.
It's a long story.
Watch it.
What the fuck? Oh. Okay, they're just getting the Wonder Woman theme song. Because that's the theme song they're using in Wonder Woman. The dimension sky, right?
Yeah.
That's all you see is the dimension sky. There we go. So who is this?
Holy shit! Oh dude!
It's the Hulk!
Oh dude! Yes!
We know each other! We're friends from work!
I don't think he remembers.
Oh, sorry. Oh my god, I'm actually very excited about that, bro. Get upset. Because I know where that scene came from, like, actually, basically. Where they took the idea for that.
Was that from the comic?
It's actually from a comic, but they changed it a bit.
Okay.
Okay, basically, like, the scene where Thor faces off the Hulk is actually in a Hulk book.
Mm.
Okay? The book is there. It's called Planet Hulk.
Okay.
This is basically after the Avengers, they couldn't decide what to do with the Hulk. They basically, okay, fuck it. We'll shoot him off to space.
Okay.
And that's what happened. And he landed on a planet where basically that's what happened. That you see him getting captured and everything. But you see, in the comic, it's actually Hulk getting captured. Hulk getting captured, and he had to fight Silver Surfer. In the comic, it was Silver Surfer. In the cartoon, it was Beta Ray Bill.
Oh,
do you know who's that?
I don't know.
It's basically, imagine Thor,
uh-huh.
but instead of a human face, it's a horse face.
Right.
Really. Okay, that's what it is. It's basically a Thor, but with a horse face, and he has the same power as Thor.
Okay.
So basically, that's what they recreated there in that trailer.
Oh.
See the part where Hulk faces off Beta Ray Bill. Uh-huh. Instead of Beta Ray Bill, they actually using Thor. So I'm actually very excited for that, because even the armor they use for that is actually from the Planet Hulk comic book.
Mm-hmm.
Where he, because in the Planet Hulk has a persona, and this is the strongest persona ever for the among all the Hulks. Just letting you know, like, okay, Hulk has many personas too. Okay, different levels of anger can trigger a different kind of level of strength, lah.
Okay.
So in basically when in that suit, if in the comic, he is the strongest Hulk has ever been.
Yeah.
So I'm actually very 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 looking forward to that fight now.
Okay, but who is the woman with the antlers though?
Sorry?
Who's the woman with the antlers there?
That girl, I'm not mistaken, she's Hera.
Hera?
It's called Hera? I think that's her name. Basically, she's...
Like, Zeus' daughter? Like, I mean, Zeus's wife?
Yes.
Hera?
Yes, something like that. Yeah, she's basically the guardian of the hell in Asgard. Of Asgard.
Oh.
You know?
That's weird.
And she tends to, in comic books, she tends to trick Thor so that she can take Thor, she can have Thor's soul.
Alright.
So basically, I'm assuming that's part of the plot there.
I see.
And Loki is involved, because Loki is a, you know, scumbag. You know? He's a trickster, you know?
So
I'm definitely looking forward to this. But there's a few things which I don't know, because Thor, I have to say, among all the Marvel books that I read, Thor is the least. Because he's completely separate from the Marvel world. Asgard tends to have their own universe going on sometimes. That's the only thing.
It's another dimension.
There's no Captain America, there's no Avengers relation, not much.
I have to say, I just saw the picture actually on Facebook today with girl with the green shirt and everything, and someone actually said that Elizabeth Banks commented on it and said like it was a ripoff of Rita from Power Rangers. I don't know if you watched that.
Okay, I
don't know. But I don't really think so. But here's the thing. I think this trailer is good. But
let's watch it again.
Let's watch it again.
You guys don't mind.
I thought he was Liam Neeson here, because like he looked a bit like Liam Neeson a bit.
What the heck?
No, he looks a bit like Liam.
We know each other. He's a friend from work.
This is that just
goodbye.
It's supposed to be funny.
Oh shit, that's epic. Thor wasn't using his hammer.
Yeah,
Thor had no hammer. It's broken already. Yeah, of course, yeah, but yeah, that's something already. That I'm looking forward to. Definitely, yeah. Man. How is Thor gonna keep up with Hulk without a hammer?
Here's the thing, I'm gonna spoil some things for you. So I think definitely that's gonna be... The trailer shows a lot about the movie. The third act is probably gonna be I think the movie's... I don't know. I have a hard time.
No, it's a lot of things going on. Like she was in hell, they're in Asgard, and then there's some technology stuff.
The hell part, I think it's gonna be the second half where the one where she breaks the hammer, Thor's hammer, is gonna be the first act.
That's definitely going to be.
Yeah, that's gonna be the first act because he's gonna come in there, and then she's gonna be like, "Yo, what's up?" And then he's gonna be like,
"Oh, okay,
yo, what you doing?"
Okay, how would you direct the movie? Would you go for a flashback type of thing, or would I, like for me, I can see being flashbacks.
I doubt they'll use
like a lot maybe of, the intro will be him in hell, and right. Then the opening scene will basically show how he got to hell, basically like her crashing the hammer,
and then after him getting losing in the fight,
losing
against,
in the fight.
Hulk. Yeah, I don't.
He will not lose.
I mean.
This is my goal.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah,
there
I
can
know.
Never
yeah,
be
yeah, yeah.
One true winner in terms of comics. Okay, I mean this because fanboys will go crazy. Like, hey, bro, Thor can do this. Oh no, Hulk can do this. You know. So yeah, there will not be a winner. Batman vs Superman. Okay, by all means. Batman vs Superman. Okay, Batman. Oh, he won. Okay, but technically he won, right? But if you think about it, if a real human is Superman, looks at Batman, he flicks him, he flies off. You know, flick! Flick! No, goodbye. So there's no challenge there technically, right? Of course, by all means, right? If Batman has a kryptonite belt, what if Krypton never fell on Earth? What if there's no single meteorite that fell on Earth? Where the fuck, right? Let's say, for example, right? You're so lucky that you happen to have that thing.
But most probably, Lex Luthor, I think, would still find out. Probably. He'd do his own research, so is all I'm saying.
Yeah. But see, the thing is,
because
of kryptonite shards, that Krypton shards that fell on Earth, that's mutated people, and I mean, that's where he went to the research.
Yeah.
So if there was no shards that fell down, only Superman on a spaceship, right, for example, how would you know where he come from, what kind of thing? There will not be a single kryptonite that can show that, oh, this is actually his weakness.
Right.
Okay, but yeah.
I'm
sorry.
This
is the first time we're doing this
together,
by the way.
This is the first time. This is the first thing.
So should we go to Justice League now?
Because
for me, I actually enjoy this a lot. I enjoy this trailer a lot. Like promise, because I've been waiting for a Planet Hulk or a World War Hulk movie,
right?
Where the Hulk just flips the table and like, screw this, I'm whacking all of you. He'll be beating Stephen Strange. He'll be beating Iron Man. He'll be beating Captain America. He'll be literally like. You know?
Yeah,
that is basically in a way like, wow. It's a teaser of that lah, for me. Because there's never been a Hulk movie since 2011? 7? I don't know. When was...
I don't remember.
Okay, when was Ed Norton?
Honestly, I didn't watch the second one. I didn't watch Thor.
Oh, didn't watch the Ed Norton one. The one that he got into the where he got recruited into the Avengers. This is why I'm crashing the channel, bro.
But no, I think maybe it's because of superhero fatigue. I don't think I'm gonna watch this one either. I'm sorry. I'm sorry to say, like,
no, it's fine.
There's nothing pulling me in this.
I mean,
because,
it's like that. It's either a fanboy or not, lah. It's best that,
Because
for me, I'm just like, cause how say I've stick for the start.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see how it continues. Though,
because even the set, it kind of looks like it was borrowed from the Flash. Cause there was an episode in the Flash, where they go to Gorilla City, and it kind of looks like that. Like the background is gray, orangey, golden.
There's a Gorilla City in Flash.
Yeah, they go to.
I have to watch it.
Yeah,
catch up on Flash.
They go to.
So what? Gorilla Groot has actually established
Gorilla
that empire.
Technically, he goes to some place, and then there is another guy, but I'm not sure if he's the ruler or not, because there was like sort of a double crossing in that episode. I forgot the master's name, by the way.
Okay,
but
okay.
That thing. So the line, I mean, you know, Thor is pretty cheesy.
Thor is Shakespeare. Thor is superhero Shakespeare, if you have to ask me. He talks like fucking Shakespeare. Okay, he talks, right? But things the way he talks is so Shakespeare.
But, there's just something about him that's quite silly. And I don't really remember that in the cartoon version of him. Like, he's in the cartoon version, they make him more of that like mighty He-Man kind of guy.
Yes, that's true. Here they play him off as like
more Shakespearean, like
more Shakespeare, more romantic.
Like
in the movie, in the comics or in the anime, it's like the mighty Thor has arrived. You dare destroy the but Odin's son, all this nonsense.
Maybe that's the charm of Chris Hemsworth rubbing off. Like, it's gone. I think it's definitely gone. Maybe it's still eye candy for the girls.
The way I look at it is, they toned it down.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because in the comics, he can be quite egoistic. Because I'm a god, right? Simple as that. I'm the protector
That's
of this
true.
Realm.
I remember that from the first one as well.
He was a bit arrogant, right?
Yeah, he's a bit arrogant.
Mm. So when he learned the lesson of humility, when the father sent him down to earth, that's where I guess they changed it.
Yeah.
I mean, he doesn't talk the same like anymore. He's more a lot more down to earth.
Yeah.
But if in the comics, he will always like the mighty Thor, the mighty Odin's son. You know, it's always like that. They have to show that Thor is a big deal in Avengers.
Right, and it seems that the biggest thing that will surround this one is Hulk not really recognizing Thor, because it doesn't seem like Hulk recognized him at all. I think
I'm hoping that this trailer, you see the part where the Hulk is. Okay, you see if I can show you in the cursor. Okay, this picture of Hulk.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
This picture of Hulk. I'm actually hoping that this is what starts off the Planet Hulk and the World War Hulk series. That's most what I'm looking for in this series, in this show. Because I have to say that I don't really follow Thor. I don't really follow Thor in Marvel. I don't really follow Thor because he's the hardest to follow. Like I say, he's in the comics. He tends to be in a separate universe.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I don't really follow the Thor comics.
You know what? I want a Green Lantern movie.
No, I don't understand. By all means, people hated the Green Lantern movie, the first one. I don't understand why. Okay, but for me, my personal opinion is that people tend to have high expectations.
I think I catched a little bit on TV, and I remember saying, "Wow, this is like the effects were shitty."
The effects were shitty.
Yeah, like I was 14 too, like, and I didn't know anything about movies yet. And I looked at it and I was like, ooh, it's just disgusting, the effects and everything. I guess if you watch it again, you'll probably see it as well.
No, for me, I watched it again and I still think it's a good, it's not a bad movie. Okay, but you cannot put it near the Avengers, of course, it's nowhere near Della. It stands alone as a superhero movie, as a solo superhero movie, it would do well. And I still think that Green Lantern, actually, Ryan Reynolds suits the role for Green Lantern. Personally, for me, I still think he suits.
But he's better as Deadpool.
But he's better. Definitely way better as Deadpool. Okay,
the
character, he's embodied it. I mean, even in the comics, even in the books, damn, Ryan Reynolds is Deadpool. Okay?
Mm.
Yeah, it's like how Iron Man is Robert Downey Jr.
Right. So, are you going to watch Thor Ragnarok?
I am going to watch that. I have to watch it. I'm a family guy. I have to go with family. And also just for the fact that I like to see things through. I try to see things through. So
I think this is going to come out after or just before
this
Guardians
September,
of the Galaxy.
September.
Oh,
this
September.
September. They already announced it September.
Okay, so it's after Guardians of the Galaxy, because Guardians of the Galaxy is going to be May. Spider-Man is going to be before Guardians.
Spider-Man, I'm still lost with Spider-Man. Okay, by all means, I like the fact that he's finally in the Avengers. Okay, he's about time he's supposed to be in Avengers. Right, but
I mean, he's your kind of guy, because you're the fast talking guy. Then this guy talks super fast.
I don't like Tom Holland as Spider-Man.
Okay, yeah, I actually prefer Andrew Garfield.
Yeah, okay, by all means, his age is right. Okay, his physique is okay. His physique is okay. I still think Andrew Garfield has the best physique of Spider-Man, all the Spider-Mans. Some people like the fact that Spider-Man is supposed to be like a kid who's being bullied.
Right.
But Andrew Garfield wasn't bullied that bad. I guess some people don't like it.
And a lot of people like that Tony Stark actually made the suit for him.
That's not right.
And
that is not right. Okay, and the suit that
I'm with you. I don't agree with that because he's supposed to be smart.
Yeah, he's supposed to be smart, making my own suit.
And a few critics like said like the generic basic suit that he made, like the one with the big eyes, and that was good for a beta test. So I'm like, yeah, that looks like a good suit, even though it looks ugly, but it's a good suit. Mm. But
for someone who started
that design. And for people to say Tony Stark giving him the suit is more of a bonding thing. I get that part.
For me no. I mean you took it away from Peter Parker. Man, come on, he created the suit. I mean, if Iron Man, Robert Downey was given the suit, it's not the same, right?
Yeah, that one is the same. But I guess. They just want something to be like, okay, they need a father figure, and
that is cool. Father figure cool, but
no, because they've killed Uncle Ben so many times.
That's not nice. Come on, don't kill him again. Yeah. Please, don't show that again. You guys shouldn't be showing this over and over again.
Because it's
like the Batman cliche, like how many times you see Martha Wayne
from Batman v Superman was very strong.
Mm.
But I like the scene when Martha got killed. Not because she got killed, just the cinematography of it was really good.
Yeah. But how many times can you show it again, right? That's why the way they did it in Batman vs Superman was quite just nice. It was short.
Yeah.
There wasn't too much in it, right?
And for me, you know, Batman vs Superman is one of the most cinematographic. Because I watched it again and I saw the cinematography and I was like, you know, this is really good.
By all means, yes, Zack Snyder is a very good.
Because I really liked his Watchmen too. You know, that's something I really enjoyed. But some people didn't like it. I don't know why, but it was very thick Watchmen, but it was still okay for me. Maybe you know because it was very artsy as well.
Watchmen is okay. Just in case you don't know, Watchmen is until now the number one graphic novel in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that?
I didn't know.
Okay, because Watchmen covers so much things that general comic books don't cover. Like, see how superheroes become from a superhero to the point they are lost. They got nothing to do. They become labeled as weapons. Is it Dr. Manhattan?
Yeah.
As much as he was developing energies and everything, and what did they do to him? Make him the enemy.
Right.
That's what they did, right? And for me, it's so good. Watchmen is so good, bro.
Yeah,
Rorschach.
Rorschach, yeah. That was one of the characters I really liked. And
the voice. Man, the guy who did the voice for Rorschach. Hands off to you, man. Thank you for playing Rorschach, bro. Really.
And I think it was because Watchmen was kind of the R, when R was that famous yet. And we saw Dr. Manhattan's dick. So that was one of the things that pushed people off, I think.
No, but yeah, that's how he is, unfortunately. How he is in the comic. Like, I mean, that's the thing. I mean, as a director, would you like to please the fans, or would you like to please the people who are watching, or would you like to please the fans who have actually been while looking for it? So from what I see from the Marvel universe in the movies, right, they're actually bridging the line pretty well.
Yeah.
They're bridging the line between like, okay, we need to do this for the audience and we need to do this for the fans, for the comic fans. And they're actually, for me personally, I think they're actually bridging it just nice.
Yeah, okay. So that's about it for Thor Ragnarok. See you in
this best is not
see you in Justice League.
I'm watching. 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 I'